So can I just talk about something I noticed when watching Lower Decks, the Star Trek animated series? Everyone talks really fast.
After we dump this in storage, let's hit the bar and see if we can get a cute lieutenant to argue with me.
Interesting. Why would you want that?
I don't know. Getting some uptight hunk all wound up
just gets me off.
Supplicate yourselves!
Ah! What the heck?
Whoa, it's one of those transdimensional energy creatures!
Behold! And tremble at me!
Quick, Tendi, grab one of those canisters!
Wait, shouldn't we call security?
I will destroy you!
No, we can use this thing for all sorts of cool stuff! Hey, grab the pod! We can figure it out later!
And why is that a big deal? The average human heartbeat is between 60 to 100 BPM, with 100 being considered quite high, so let's watch this clip again with a metronome set to, say, 70 beats per minute.
After we dump this in storage, let's hit the bar and see if we can get a cute lieutenant to argue with me.
Interesting. Why would you want that?
I don't know. Getting some uptight hunk all wound up
just gets me off.
Supplicate yourselves!
Ah! What the heck?
Whoa, it's one of those transdimensional energy creatures!
Behold! And tremble at me!
Quick, Tendi, grab one of those canisters!
Wait, shouldn't we call security?
I will destroy you!
No, we can use this thing for all sorts of cool stuff! Hey, grab the pod! We can figure it out later!
See what I'm getting at here? Let's watch it again with a BPM of 160.
After we dump this in storage, let's hit the bar and see if we can get a cute lieutenant to argue with me.
Interesting. Why would you want that?
I don't know. Getting some uptight hunk all wound up
just gets me off.
Supplicate yourselves!
Ah! What the heck?
Whoa, it's one of those transdimensional energy creatures!
Behold! And tremble at me!
Quick, Tendi, grab one of those canisters!
Wait, shouldn't we call security?
I will destroy you!
No, we can use this thing for all sorts of cool stuff! Hey, grab the pod! We can figure it out later!
And in case you think they're talking fast because this is an action scene, let's do the same thing with the next scene.
What you watching?
That's this video of Vice Admiral Gibson falling off a stage during peace negotiations. You gotta check it out.
That's Guess which command ensign just scored the best assignment on the ship?
Castro.
No, not Castro.
Ugh, too bad. She's the best.
Castro's overrated. Just because she served on the Enterprise for like 1 minute.
Oh, was it Pajok? That guy can do anything.
And what a snack.
No, it's me. I got it. I'm the guy that got it, okay?
What you watching?
That's this video of Vice Admiral Gibson falling off a stage during peace negotiations. You gotta check it out.
That's Guess which command ensign just scored the best assignment on the ship?
Castro.
No, not Castro.
Ugh, too bad. She's the best.
Castro's overrated. Just because she served on the Enterprise for like 1 minute.
Oh, was it Pajok? That guy can do anything.
And what a snack.
No, it's me. I got it. I'm the guy that got it, okay?
I mean, it's odd, right? It's not just me. If we were to compare this show to another contemporary sci-fi cartoon, any one random contemporary sci-fi cartoon that has no other reason to make any comparisons to this other than the speech pattern, we'd probably look at Final Space.
Gary, you have 8 minutes of oxygen left.
You, if you had 8 minutes to live and you could do anything you wanted, what would you do?
Facticulating. I would transfer my AI into a corporeal being and go see Paris.
Oh, that's lame!
Gary, you have 8 minutes of oxygen left.
You, if you had 8 minutes to live and you could do anything you wanted, what would you do?
Facticulating. I would transfer my AI into a corporeal being and go see Paris.
Oh, that's lame!
You see how that's weird, right? Maybe I'm not being fair because this is a particularly slow scene, so let's find one where there is some dialogue being conveyed.
What the heck is this thing?
A Ventrexian stealth probe. Turk.
Of course, Turk. Who the hell's Turk?
A bounty hunter, like me. If he scanned Mooncake, he'll be on his way back to the Lord Commander to gather reinforcements. Mm-hmm. Unless we stop him first. Mm-hmm. If we don't, they will capture Mooncake. Mm-mm. And take us to the Dark Zone. Mm-mm. And torture us with Zargon slugs. Mm-mm. Where we're gonna suffer pain and anguish for eternity. Ooh. And the only way to stop them is with salt. Oh. And there's no salt in the Dark Zone.
See, you even get a sense of the character and the humor from this conversation. But okay, the protagonist isn't talking, so that's not fair either. Let's do a BPM comparison on a scene that has all the same character and humor established and stuff, but with some dialogue from protagonist Gary.
Get me out of these cuffs, and we'll go after him.
Whoa, cowboy! You tried to kill me! If you want me to trust you, first we clasp.
I'm not doing that.
Oh, yes, you will! You will do that! We've enjoyed recreational cards together. This is the next step!
Get me out of these cuffs, and we'll go after him.
Whoa, 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 cowboy! You tried to kill me! If you want me to trust you, first we clasp.
I'm not doing that.
Oh, yes, you will. You will do that. We've enjoyed recreational cards together. This is the next step.
Why even draw attention to this? Because of what I was just talking about there. Dialogue is meant to convey character and expand on the story. That floaty-like thing from Lower Decks does not come up again once in this episode. And that's not even touching on the more obvious problem that they're talking so fast, you don't really pick up on what they're saying all the time. In sci-fi, you've got to establish a lot of new concepts quickly and efficiently, which means big chunks of dialogue, so you need to convey that dialogue efficiently.
What the hell?
That thing is an Autobage. It's gonna implant eggs in your throat, dummy.
What are you doing?
Okay, that's an Abenage. I don't know anything about Star Trek. Tell me more about what an Abenage is. Is this good thing or is it bad? Or...
I've never even heard of an Autobage. How did you know?
Affinity for red, drawn to the weak-minded. Plus, I kind of dated one once, but only to make my mom mad.
Weak-minded?
An Andorian in the bathroom said the general's at a bar just down the road. Come on, you can tell me about Jamaharan later.
Like... what was that? Mariner mentioned another alien race as well as pushing the plot along there, and you could have easily missed it. My beef with this show so far, there's only two episodes, so, you know, it might get better, is there's nothing drawing me into the Star Trek universe, and not being able to listen to the dialogue without having an anxiety attack is not helping. If we were, again, to compare this show to Final Space has so much more going for it. Not just because it's an original story that gets to invent original characters, so original that some of the characters they've invented appear to have inspired other shows, but the story is as sad as it is beautiful. It's as fun as it is funny. It's a fun space cartoon about loss and loneliness that has an epic adventure quality to it. It has a unique colour scheme of its own, and some of the alien designs are so good. Now, I like the main story of Lower Decks as it was laid out. These are the unappreciated worker bees who do all the grunt work stuff while the people on the bridge take all the glory. I'm even on board with what I'm guessing is going to be the plot for the series that we laid out pretty obviously in the first episode, in which we find out that Mariner is the captain's daughter who's refusing to join command because they all suck. But I don't think that premise has got a lot of legs. Not in the way Final Space does. And that worries me because it's going to have to rely more on the inbuilt characters of the Trek universe because that's where easy material is and that'll make the old fans happy, but it's going to lose new fans like me. I only wanted to make this video to mention the fast talking thing. My thing is comedy. My video essays, let me tell you why that's funny, are all about comic theory and all that jazz. I'm just a big fan of animation. But as a fan, I would have thought it was obvious there was a problem with the recording here. The voice director could have easily have solved my biggest problem with this show by saying, hey, you were talking a bit fast on that take, maybe we can try another one where you slow it down. You know, Tom Kenny is an established part of Final Space, and he's in this episode of Lower Decks we're looking at here too, and you can tell how much the pace changes when the character is on screen. This isn't really Lower Decks' fault as much as it is an industry-wide problem of not using voice actors for voice actor gigs. I like Tony Newsom, who plays Mariner. I'm not sold on this Jack Quaid guy, but to be fair to him, his character is a bit of a dud, so that doesn't help. She's a good actor, and she's generally funny in the things I've seen her in. I don't think she's to blame here. I think it boils down to a problem with the showrunner, not saying, hey, we need to let some moments breathe here, so people know what's going on, so they can get used to the show and the universe we're trying to draw them into, and so they can breathe themselves. Well, that's my animation observation for the day. Like I say, my other video essay series, Let Me Tell You Why That's Funny, is available on the channel too. Please go check that out. Or don't. Let's all hope that this series gets better anyway, because, you know, Rick and Morty kind of has done some damage to the sci-fi cartoon genre while also, ironically, kind of inventing it as well. So there's a topic. Maybe I can talk about that next time. Maybe I will talk about that next time. You'll have to subscribe to Top Hats and Canes on YouTube to find out if I do.